What's good, people? It's your boy Clan, the Spurs fan, here with a brand new video. I want to talk about this. Here's a public service announcement. When are we going to leave Trey Lyles alone? I mean, seriously, when are we going to leave the guy alone? Give the man a break. He is a tremendous talent that the San Antonio Spurs are acquiring. Yes, did I want Marcus Morris? Of course. Everyone wanted Marcus Morris. But at the end of the day, after he pulled what he just pulled, you should realize that we did not want that guy. Because his mind is somewhere else. His mind wouldn't have been fully invested into winning. He has other plans. He wants more. He needs more money, more publicity. He's planning straight up for his future. And the San Antonio Spurs are a team that acquires guys that gets over themselves. So at the end of the day, it wouldn't have worked out anyway. But I say all that to say this. Just because we don't have a guy, because everyone says that we need toughness. Everybody says that we want toughness. We want as many tough guys as we can get. Let me ask you something. Would a team with Tony Parker, Manu Ginobili, Kawhi Leonard, Tim Duncan, Jonathan Simmons, David West, Danny Green, would a team with all those pieces, LaMarcus Aldridge, would a team with all those pieces and all that talent, you think that's championship worthy? What if I told you they won 67 games? Wouldn't you just assume that, yes, that's a team that's going to the finals, that's a team that can win it all, that's a team that should win it all. But what if I told you that same team lost in the second round? So it's not all about talent. It's not all about just grit and toughness. It's not about all that. When you're a San Antonio Spurs team, you have to have the right pieces to run the offense accordingly. We all were super excited about David West. We got David West. It did not pan out. He was not as great or as good as we expected him to be as a veteran and as a tough guy. So don't just assume if we would have got Marcus Morris that it would have just worked out and everything would have been great and dandy. It doesn't necessarily work like that. Look, we got our toughness. We got Damari Carroll. We got DeJounte Murray. We have Derek White. We have plenty of guys on this team that's tough. Jakob Poeltl don't get enough credit from people. He's a tough guy. But the teams that win, the San Antonio Spurs teams that win and go after a championship, they all do it from up here. They all do it from basketball IQ. This guy that we're acquiring is the equivalent of Boris Diaw and Kyle Anderson. As someone stated in our last live stream, he is a mixture of those two with athleticism. The dude can play. Allow him to grow within the Spurs system. Allow him to play under Pop and see what he can do. Most of you guys who are sitting here talking bad about him and saying that he's not going to do this, he's not going to do that, he's averaged this many points, blase. He had 25% three-point shooting. I guarantee that you haven't watched one Trey Lyles game. I guarantee it. So don't sit here and assume everything. Stats are not everything. The guy had some injury issues last year. He didn't play tremendously well. He barely played. I mean, he averaged about 17 minutes. But allow the guy to grow under Popovich. This is a tremendous talent. He was a 12th overall draft pick for a reason. And let him fit in the Spurs system. And if I'm being completely honest, when I was coming up with my starting lineup, and this is pre-Marcus Morris, this is pre-knowing that Marcus Morris was going to back out, I was creating that video. I was thinking about it. I was thinking about who should be our starting lineup, who should come off the bench. And honestly, if I'm being completely honest, I wasn't quite sure. In back of my mind, because I wanted to work, because Marcus Morris is a really good player. But in the back of my mind, I was thinking maybe he would not fit in our system well enough. And one thing that he is really good at, Marcus Morris, he's good at shot creating. And I said this in the video. He's good at shot creating. But we also need a guy that's going to just play his role. We just need a guy that can just be a kind of a spot-up shooter, can pass the ball, make the right decisions. Marcus Morris is not a playmaker. This season has a season that is wide open. The last Western Conference team that been to the finals was the San Antonio Spurs in 2014. Now it's wide open and we can get right back there. But instead of dogging on Trey Lyles, how about we support him and be happy that we even got this piece? When nothing came out about Marcus Morris, that we were even going to acquire Marcus Morris, we were all excited and saying San Antonio Spurs, Western Conference Finals, San Antonio Spurs Finals. But now all of a sudden, since Marcus Morris did what he did, and we add more talent than we had before, now we're doomed. And we possibly won't even make the playoffs. Come on, y'all. Come on. We got to do better as fans. Give the guy a break. Give the guy a break. It can work. I feel like it will work. He has extremely high basketball IQ. And we all know when it comes to Greg Popovich, that's one of the most important. It's the most important thing you can have to get minutes. It's not all about talent with Pop. And the guy, and I keep saying it's not all about talent, but the guy is talented also. But give the guy a break. Give the guy a break. But that's it for today. That's all I wanted to talk about, because I've been seeing so many negative comments regarding this pickup. And it's really sad. It's really sad at this point. But I'll get with you guys next time. Till next time, Spurs Knights. Deuces.